Dear students, we had many discussions regarding world wars, Indo-Pak conflict. Today, we can have a discussion on India-China relations. Right from independence, we had a very good relation with China. When Mao Tse-tung was ruling China, China became independent in 1948. But we became independent country in 47 only. Chou En Lai was invited to our Republic Day parade as a guest. That time we had a very good relations. We signed Panchashila. The very popular slogan was in progress in those days, Hindi Chini Bhai Bhai. Till 1962, India-China had a very good relations, very friendly countries. But if China made a sudden attack on 24th, October 1962 in two areas, Ladakh and Nepal areas, acquired nearly 37,000 kilometers of Indian territory. Since then, the relations between these two countries were strained. But as per the WTO norms, agreements, China was sending its goods into our country and we were sending some of our goods to China. Import export was going on under the WTO, its World Health, World Trade Organization. But after this, after 1962, on November 21st, 1962, when China had unilaterally made attack on India on 24th October, on 21st November 62, after 1 month, unilaterally declared ceasefire. It took back its army to McMahon Line. The border line between India and China is called a McMahon line. It withdrew up to McMahon line. Then once again, the relations started normalizing between the countries. When Rajiv Gandhi became Prime Minister, that time many agreements were made between India and China. In 67 itself, when the China made attack when India was not prepared, it is not because of our military, it is because of our politicians. When our military leaders have informed the politicians that China is making roads in the border area, it may plan to attack on India, but in spite of warning, our leaders remained silent. Though without any preparation, our soldiers fought well, sacrificed themselves, and anyway we have to accept the defeat in 62. In 67 only, befitting answer was given to Chinese army by the Indian army, because Indian army prepared at that time. The befitting answer was given to them. And in 1972, the Nepal area, Nepal Northeast Frontier Agency in Arunachal Pradesh, some area was attacked by China and captured. An Indian government declared that Nepal area made a separate state called Arunachal Pradesh, declared as one of the states of Indian Union. and in 1987 it was included in the Indian Union. In 1958, we had good relation with China at that time. China by force wanted to acquire Taiwan. Actually, it was Taiwan which was given the permanent Security Council member. UN has declared or recognized Taiwan as a China, because the complete China was ruled by Taiwan until 1960. And Mao Tse-tung came to power, they tried to include Taiwan also in China and make it a part of China. And this China started becoming powerful because it is a communist country, people are made to work hard, given less salary, even without salary also they are made to work. That way China started growing economically. When there was a North Korea-South Korea war, China helped North Korea. When was a North Vietnam-South Vietnam war, China helped North Vietnam. North Vietnam was helped by China and Russia both. But in 1958 only, America wanted to throw atom bomb on China to teach it a lesson, as America taught a lesson to Japan in 1945. But because of the fear of Russia, the Cold War has started between Russia and America. Russia also was an atomic country. Russia may stand to the support of China. With that fear, America did not throw atom bomb on China. But China, Pakistan is a well-known enemy of India. China thought that enemy is a friend. Pakistan is an Indian enemy of India, and China also has become an enemy of India from 1962 onwards. Without involving directly in conflict with India, it wanted to encourage Pakistan to engage in conflict with India. So it was giving all possible help to Pakistan. Even it helped for the Pak Economic Corridor, which is running through POK. China's policy, India should remain subordinate to it, and India-China became one power. There will be none to defeat India and China, because population-wise both are heavy populated countries, and it wanted to suppress India by helping the neighboring countries of India, that is Bhutan, Nepal, Tibet. Already by force it has taken. Dalai Lama of Tibet is given shelter in India. That was the reason for China to attack on India. But anyway, the small countries around India, which are supposed to be a buffer states, China is trying to help these countries and to make them as anti-Indian countries. China is financing them and supplying them weapons, giving all sorts of help so that they can become and anti-Indian pockets. So every neighboring country of India, Nepal once upon a time wanted to join India. That also is once again a mistake of our first Prime Minister. He did not allow Nepal to become a part of India. But now the Maoists are helped in Nepal. We have a cultural relation, blood relation, everything with Nepal. But even then, recently Nepal also has become an enemy country to India. China is helping all of them. Myanmar, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, Pakistan, Afghanistan, all these countries are helped by China economically, and China supplies automatic weapons to these Maoist Naxalites to create disturbance in India and neighboring countries also. China has not given a donation to Pakistan to develop its corridor. It has given a loan to Pakistan so that permanently it should become an economically slave country to China. Though a lot of atrocities are done on Muslims in China, Pakistan never says a single word to China. Though the Muslims in India are looked after very well, if any small incident takes place, an individual, maybe an individual problem, there Pakistan raises the problem that there is a lot of atrocities are going on Muslims in India. But Chinese Muslims are not allowed to have a beard. Chinese Muslims are not allowed to have a burqa. They are not allowed to have a namaz in public place. But even then, Pakistan never says a single word against China. Almost it has become a slave of China. And when we are a nuclear power, so it wanted Pakistan also to become a nuclear power. It is China which has helped Pakistan to become nuclear power and to develop its rocket technology, developed its harbor. As per the WTO agreement, World Trade Organization agreement, Chinese goods are allowed in India. Lot of money, hundreds together crore is earned by the Chinese goods, and the same money is sent to the neighboring countries to have an anti-Indian activities. And Kailash Parvat, Manas Sarovar, which are in the borders of India and China, acquired by China, and Indians are not allowed to visit the places. In 1988, when Rajiv Gandhi visited China, some agreements were made that both the countries should fight against terrorism. Some joint military exercises were conducted. But after that, China continued to help Nepal, Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, Pakistan. Though joint military operations, agreement to fight against terrorism was agreed, but still China is helping Nepal that Naxalites should enter into the India, because India and Nepal have a free border. There is no proper checkup. And recently also, China has crossed the McMahon line. During Morarji Desai's premiership, George Fernandes was a defense minister, and he decided to develop the border roads throughout the McMahon line. When China has developed any time it may attack on us, so we also keep all our roads in the border developed properly so that there should be immediate license, communication, transportation, everything. George Fernandes took a very good decision, and recently also In Galwan Ghati, Chinese army entered, but Indian army had already learnt a lesson in 1962. It wanted to have a revenge on Chinese army. In Galwan Ghati, Indian army has given a good lesson to China. But even then, China is not getting rid of its habits. Time and again, it is trying to send its soldiers crossing the McMahon line. And at the same time, China, with the help of Pakistan, always opposing India to become a permanent Security Council member. If India becomes a permanent Security Council member, it will have a veto power. Many times, both Pakistan and China have opposed India to become a Security Council member. Anyway, both China and Pakistan are not believable countries. We should always be well prepared against these two countries. We should always be watching carefully the borders, both Red Cliff Line between India and Pakistan, the McMahon Line between India and China, should be always kept under strict vigilance, not only of our soldiers, but even our, you can send some satellites also to keep a watch throughout these two lines. To achieve this, once again, the tit-for-tat policy should be adopted by India. Chinese population is bigger than us, but Chinese population is not patriotic as Indian population is. The population of communist country cannot be patriotic, cannot help the government during emergencies. But it is the population of democratic country which helps the government and stand by the government by doing all possible help. So we should be always careful regarding China and Pakistan. Both are not a country to be believed. Should well prepared and ready to give a befitting answer, as said by Lal Bahadur Shastri in 65, Int ka jawab patthar se. So unless we adopt this policy, we cannot progress. And at the same time, we should make our people a workaholic like Japanese. Our idle population should be taught a proper lesson by using many other methods, making them to work hard and contribute their might in the progress of the nation. I hope our relations with China is very clear, and how careful we should be regarding these two countries, Pakistan and China. Leave about the people above 60, but the young people of this country should be aware of these two enemy countries, so that we should be ready to give a befitting answer to them. Thank you, one and all.